I think this is working. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay, great. I'm Jennifer Lucht. I'm the director of the Carolina Chamber Music Festival. I see some familiar faces and maybe some new faces. I'm wondering how many people have been to a festival event before. Yeah. Thank you. And how many people have not been to a festival event? Great. Well, welcome. Fantastic. We're so happy to have you here, as well as our returning folks, of course. Today we are going to have a working rehearsal for David Leahy's piece 300, which we will be giving the world premiere of tomorrow night, right here on this very stage, or this very altar. The piece, I just wanted to tell you a little bit about how the piece came about. The Carolina Chamber Music Festival has been presenting concerts in New Bern for the past 13 years. We are having our 13th season right now, and it corresponds with the 300th anniversary of Christ Episcopal Church. Over the years, we have had the pleasure of being able to integrate our programs, which involve artists who primarily come from other areas of the country. We've started integrating more local musicians who are wonderful, and we really enjoy the exchange that we have with the artists that are here in New Bern. Of course, David and Rachel Pino on violin is gracing us with her presence, playing with us. And like I was saying, we have started integrating with the community just a little bit more in celebrations. We actually had a special piece written for the 300th anniversary of the town back in 2010, and have done some other things along the way. So we're very pleased that we were able to participate in this particular celebration, which is going on for a whole year, is that right? Yes, many, many events, as many of you know, here at the church and other places in celebration. So we were asked to be performers for this piece and collaborate with David some on some aspects of the piece. And so David, he'll tell you a little bit more about the piece himself. We were able to talk about what the instrumentation is for the piece, and with our forces, we had to think, well, what other things are we programming this week? We do have three concerts this week. What instruments would we have available? What instruments was David interested in using in his piece? And then find a good meeting place with those two things. And we have come up with what I think is a really lovely ensemble with many different colors in it, musically, instrumentally. So I'll go ahead and introduce the musicians, and then I'll hand it over to David, and he can tell you a little more about the piece. So today we have Ann Bobo, who's playing flute. And Ann is from Boston. Gabby Diaz, violin, also from Boston. Rachel Pino, from right here in New Bern. Studied in Boston, I have to say. Nina Ferrigno is playing piano. Nina is from St. Louis, also studied in Boston. I'm from Boston, can you tell? Amadi Azakiwe, and where would you say you're from these days?
New York.
Okay, Amadi.
Studied in Boston. Yeah.
And Nancy Dimmick on oboe, also from Boston. I did grow up in Greenville. I just want to throw that in there. So.
Okay, David.
Good. Structurally, what we'll do during our time together here is after David speaks, we'll go ahead and we'll rehearse. If anyone's having a tough time hearing and would like to come closer, it's pretty informal, so just move. You're not going to bother us, come on up and get a little closer if you want to hear more of what we're saying. We'll try to speak up, though. And then we'll take some questions and answers at the end.
Okay, good morning, everybody.
Good morning,
everybody.
Good morning.
It's going to be a long hour. Thank you all so much for being here. I want to thank the musicians, too. They sound incredible. We had our first run through of this on Wednesday. And it was special for me because, I could hear it for the first time. And since July, I've had it played through a MIDI system with sort of synthesized strings and a synthesized flute and everything else. So it was actually nice to hear it for its first time on Wednesday. They played it really well, but we're hopefully going to make a few more changes this morning. So when I was originally asked to do this, I didn't really know where to start. I kind of thought about New Bern and Christchurch and what it all meant to me and to the people. And so the piece is sort of in three movements. The first one is called The River, for obvious reasons. And the second one is called Processional, linking it hopefully with, hopefully you can see in your mind the reality of it from the wake back when Christchurch, 300 years ago, was born. And then the final movement is simply called Celebration, to celebrate the fact that Christchurch is still here after 300 years. Instrumentation that Jennifer talked about, I'd like to think that there was a discussion regarding that, but she told me the instruments I had to deal with, so I just dealt with it. Kidding. I wanted some drums and some keyboards and everything else. No, and maracas. No, I'm kidding. But this is a wonderful, wonderful setup, and it's going to be nice for me to sit down here and actually listen to it tomorrow evening rather than performing, so I can just show up. That's going to be great. I would certainly like to open it up if anybody has any questions right now, just before we start rehearsing, or we can just go straight into it. And then if you have any questions at the end, feel free to shout out or come up and talk to me, that's fine. So if you're happy, we'll start rehearsing. Okay, we're not gonna play at all though. You gotta come back tomorrow night. Tell everything that I'm doing through this microphone so you can hear exactly what I'm saying. So that's good news. We're gonna play from the first movement into the second movement, just to get the transition correct, I guess is the word. Okay, so this is the end of the first movement into the second movement. All right. All right, go for it. Let's try it again without that decay. Just so I can hear it. Still from Mars, yeah. Without as much time? Okay, okay, so just keep counting through it.
Yeah.
Okay, let's try it. All right. Yeah, same spot. Yeah, let's do that. Okay, 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 okay. That's good. And then when we get into that bit there, strings, you could be more, not quite as, have you had enough? Are we paying him by the minute? yeah, maybe like as the first movement is so flowing that we need that sort of change. So more, what's the word I'm looking for? Almost just stronger on the processional, yeah. A little bit separated, yeah. Yes, the way you did it then was perfect. That's the way I meant it. I just couldn't write it. Yeah. Yeah, the whole piece needs to be rerun. Like, 24 hours.
You didn't know this was going to be a comedy show.
Okay.
You were all commenting on how beautifully the parts are, actually, and how it's all laid out beautifully, and it's very well made.
It's $20 well spent. Okay. Same place, 2 before. That sounds good. Let me just push it a little bit. A little bit quicker. I just don't want it to sound too much like the first movement, too slow. because like I said, we've all got lives to lead. Yeah, that was perfect. That was perfect. Okay, well, don't worry too much about the speed. Let's move on a little bit. Let's go to the string bit, 94. And the strings of the tune. No, measure 94. What are you moaning about? Is there an error? Okay, yeah, measure 94. Trills, so they're incredible. Whoever wrote this, right? Yeah, so Stop Die When. I think maybe even Jennifer with that bomb, 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 simple stuff, but just maybe just go right through legato, maybe. As we go. All right, where are we going from? Same place, 94, yeah. Guys can play. Going into the measure, yeah, one or two was good. Just don't die away, like at all. There, 102, pretty big, and then I want you to get to really loud when you get to the allegro. Okay, so just keep the volume up. I think it worked well. I think that was good. I just want a bigger when you get into the third movement. Bam, and then it sort of shuts down a little bit. You know what I mean? So the as much as you can give. Let's just. Yeah, because you have the melody line, yeah? You're doing the melody line, yeah? So cut off. Mm-hmm. Yeah, because we've got a G sharp in there. That's why it wouldn't work. See the way I did that? I'm learning. I'm learning what notes go together and what ones don't. Okay, let's go from there. Yeah, 4 before, so 4 before the Allegro. This was the third movement, you may have noticed. This is a little bit quicker. So we just did the second processional into the final movement, so okay. Don't slow down on those measures. You're doing the melody line perfect. Can we try a little bit quicker? Oh, yeah. Try a bit quicker. I think you're just killing them on your own. I think it sounds okay. Yeah. So let's just go from 118. Yeah, so it's da 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 da. Yeah. Yep. Because I know it's so great to play. It's such a... But just quieten it down a bit. Not too much, though. And tempo's perfect. That's the tempo. All right. So the next we need to do is the middle bit of the last movement. When we have the oboe and flute doing that little reflective moment. So let's go from 152. Yeah. Yeah, you can. Yeah. Yeah, because it's different. Just make a difference. Yeah, to the other bits. Thank you. make it sound out of control, I guess. Because again, I know you're all very, very excited. Just to make it out of control. You came in perfect volume, but then just push it on, and you guys obviously listen to what's underneath you, so you can hear the tempo change and all that. So, all right, let's just go from a few measures before that. Perfect. That's exactly what I was going to say. 169. I can do what I want. So, measure 193. Repeat back to the allegro. We'll do all that section again. You know what I'm saying? So put a repeat from 193 right back to not the first allegro. We'll be here all day. Well, 175. Put a repeat mark in there. Yeah, adding a repeat. Yeah, 193 is this one here, right? Yeah, you play 193, and then you go back to here. Just feel like we get to the end too soon. You know, I put all this work into it, maybe we'll hear it again, right? I don't know, I just feel like we get there too soon. Does what? Does somebody yell? Well, I'll do it. One more time! Okay, do you want to try that? You're okay with that? We can run it tomorrow. I guess we're going to run the whole thing tomorrow, right? I want to do the beginning, for sure. I think if we know what we're doing at the beginning, it might help. And again, the tempo, that's all really. Just getting the tempo sort of started. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Thank you. Yeah. Just come straight in, and that was a perfect tempo. Measure 9, or do you want to come in when you come in? The flute at measure 16. 16? Okay, then pick up to 17. Those. Just chill. Relax. Okay. Easy. We'll run through it all tomorrow. Okay, thank you guys. So there you have it in little bits. Hopefully it'll be a lot better than that tomorrow. I'm kidding, they did a great job. Give them a round of applause, please. Do you want to take over? Why not?
Does anyone have any questions about what we were working on or observations they would like to share with us? It's always interesting for us to hear how you were hearing the music that we're playing. Oh, good, good. Thank you. Thank you. Bravo, David. One thing that occurred to me when we were rehearsing up here is that we're doing more than just rehearsing and trying to get our parts together and considering musical phrasing ideas, that sort of thing. We're actually really working on the composition of the piece. We're actually changing a few things. You know, are we going to be holding this note and actually putting a marking in that would indicate for other people who will play it after us to know, hold this note longer than the bar, or will we just, you know, musically decide to stretch it in our performance, but that wouldn't actually be indicated for people who would be playing it after us. So some of these things, writing dynamics that the composer then will put in his part and then give to other people who will be playing the piece, or are those just things that we're going to be doing for our performance. So there was a little bit of both of those type of things going on, and that's always fun for us when we're working on a new piece with a composer to sort of help in that writing process, if you will. It's a very small contribution, but it nonetheless is very fun for us and a collaborative thing that we can do with the composer. So. And not all composers are as open to that as others, so it's nice to work with David. Yes?
I have a question. Say that you have three parts to this beautiful piece. Where were you physically?
Well, I can't really divulge every location. No, I'm kidding. It was in my living room, every single bit of it. I sat down and wrote it in my living room, but the actual thoughts and all those melody lines and all those different bits, the tunes and themes were all sort of, I would sing into my phone and record it. As I was at stoplights, I would never do it when I was driving. I was caught humming it in the office by Paul. Yeah, he looked at me very strange. There's never ever one location. I mean, I had to sit down and actually write it. I actually didn't have a piano at home until I didn't decide to write it. When I was commissioned to write this piece, I needed something that was going to be able to do something. I didn't really want to do it at the church because, you know, I get hassled at church when I work here. You know, it's the way it goes. So I wanted to be at home, and I got it. I actually went all the way to Virginia Beach and bought a piano, electric piano, a very nice piano, and brought it home, and I plugged in my laptop and started recording things into it, I've said it all week to different media things, I just can't describe how I come up with them. It just sort of happens. Oh, I have visions. I have visions, but not necessarily anything. I mean, the water, when you look at water, you think of the up and down movement of it all, and you hear it in the cello at one point. You definitely hear it in the piano, that da 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 da. You're welcome. You're welcome. Anybody else? Yes.
I was just going to say, to me, it captures the places, but you're kind of taken through the time periods too.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Yes.
Dave, are you doing this manuscript, or are you using a software program to write the entire score together at one time to see the whole thing?
I have got some manuscripts. If I would be wherever I was and just write it all, write bits and pieces down, not legible, but you know, I can at least I could work it out what it meant. But then, as great as it is to have a software program, it never does what you tell it to. So you print, you play it all in, and then you have to sit there for another few hours trying to really put it all into. It's tedious. Yeah, just letting you all know that. But yeah, software. Anyone? Yes, Ken. Thank you. I'm happy to have proceeds go to the Dave Lehay for extra fund for extra activities. I don't know. I mean, we are going to record it tomorrow night, the whole thing, but I think they're just going to be available, right? Okay, so it could be a hefty sum. Yeah, but I think that's all. No? Yes? Anybody else? Okay. They've got to get busy with the rest of their program. They've got to do some important stuff like Bach and Vaughan Williams and stuff.
Actually, funny you mentioned that. I was just thinking how I was really thrilled when David sent the piece to me, and I guess that was late July. You know what? He is one of the only composers that's early to a deadline, I just have to say. So thank you. Thank you, David. But excuse me. When he one of the benefits of electronics is that he was able to send the music to me by email, and so we talked about it a little bit just over the phone after I had reviewed it, and I was very excited about it, partly because I thought it fit the entire program so well, because I had gone ahead and programmed the first half, and then the Bach Brandenburg Fifth Concerto is going to be last on the program after David's piece. So those were already set. And David's piece was just such a perfect fit in that program. And I think some of that is because of the way that he was considering place and time in his music, which many of the other pieces on the program do as well. And his countrymen, Samuel Coleridge Taylor and Ralph Vaughan Williams, and Handel, all of these other pieces that are on the program by English composers definitely have a sense of place and time. Coleridge Taylor's quartet that we're going to be playing, they're fantasy pieces. Each one has a very distinct character to it and very different from one another. And Vaughan Williams, I mean, you can just listen to it and imagine that you're in the English countryside, I think, in the fantasy quintet. And David's piece really fits so nicely. I think also because of his tonal approach to the harmonies. Some of the pieces that we have commissioned in the past have been a little bit more atonal. The harmonies just very different than what you find in kind of traditional or older classical music. So I'm very excited about that. I think you'll enjoy the flow of the concert if you're coming tomorrow night. And if you don't have a ticket for tomorrow and you would like one, I can either, I have some for sale right now, or I can take your name and make a reservation for you. We should also have some tickets available at the door, but they're a hot commodity because of this piece. So, you know, I'd say do it now. So anyway, thank you so much for being here today. We're really happy that you came out. We haven't had a lot of open rehearsals in the past few years, and this was really fun for us to do for you today. So thank you, and we hope to see you tomorrow.